The good news about Jesus is that once he saves you, he doesn't leave you. God doesn't visit you and then abandon you. The same power that transformed you initially is the same power that will transform you progressively. He walks with you. And the journey becomes us trusting Jesus. That I receive it. Salvation happens in a moment. Now I'm on the process. Now I'm on the journey of becoming like Jesus. And if I'm going to become like Jesus, well, friends, Romans 8 says crazy stuff like, if I want to share in his glory, I got to also be willing to share in his suffering. I think one of the great misleadings that I feel like I grew up with was we thought that faith could prevent suffering. We thought that we could just name it and claim it and just speak it out and that we wouldn't have any problems. Well, if that was the case, every faith healer and every teacher I know that teaches that, why don't they just get rid of the plague right now? Why don't they just get rid of the pandemic? It's because suffering is a result of this thing called sin, and we're still on this earth. But now that I'm in Christ, I can reframe and redefine the suffering that I'm going through, and I don't have to waste my pain. And this is a word for someone right now. Don't waste your pain. God will use seasons of suffering to speak to you. C.S. Lewis said, God whispers in our pleasures, but he shouts in our pain. And I don't know about you, but in this 9 weeks that I have been quarantined, I am seeing a brand new facet of God. I'm discovering new things about myself and new things about God, but I'm deciding in my sanctification process that the one who saved me by grace, the one who's walking with me side by side, that as I get into the valley, he didn't promise I wouldn't go into the valley. He didn't promise I wouldn't go into the fire. He didn't promise me that I wouldn't fall. He just promised me that he would go through every one of those elements with me. Every one of those seasons, he would walk with me side by side. And I have decided that a waiting season doesn't have to be a wasted season. That even while I'm in this season where I hear negative news, the economy, suffering, death, that I have decided that I'm being sanctified in Jesus. I'm on my way to heaven. Until I get to heaven, I'm bringing heaven down to earth. And I don't have to waste any season, even when the season provides suffering, calamity, even when the season brings death to my doorstep. I'm going to discover that I serve a God who is sovereign and big, and he is working all things together for his good. He's working it all together for his good and our good, for those that love and trust him.